than that, I'm just glad that you are here. If you haven't already, be sure to say hello in the comment section of the video. It's always a blessing to others to know that you are here worshiping with us. Now I'd like to invite you to say the things that unite us here as a church family. I encourage you, wherever you are, to say these things out loud. I know it can be a little strange talking to your computer screen or phone or wherever you are, but I really think it helps us kind of unite and remind us that we are united with much more than physical presence, but that we are also united in the things that we believe. And so you can join now the people here in the sanctuary in person, and we can say these things together. Here we go. Here at Connect Church, our mission is to connect to God and connect to others. And our vision is to share the transforming power of Christ by creating a community set on making a difference in the world by living out Christ's three greats, the great commandment: to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The commandment of great compassion. Truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me. And the Great Commission: go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And while these are the things that unite us here at Connect Church, we are also united with Christians around the world. And so each week, we join their voices in saying the Apostles' Creed together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And now if you'll join me in prayer, and then we will worship together. Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you so much for being here with us today. We ask that you would send your spirit into this place and be present with all of us who are worshiping at home. We ask that you bless us, enable us to encounter you. God, be with us. We thank you so much for being the God that you are. In your holy and wonderful name we pray. Amen.
Every chain will break as broken hearts declare his praise. But who can stop the Lord Almighty? Our God is the Lion of Judah. He's roaring with power and fighting our battles, and every knee will bow before.
Today, we are having something very special happen here at Connect Church. We have several positions of leadership at the church, and one of the most important positions of leadership here at the church is our lay leader. He chairs our kind of executive board here at the church, helping us make decisions. Sort of helps me make plans about where we're going and what we're doing. But anyway, his name is Ryan Hayes, and Ryan has come today to bring the message to you. He has prayed diligently about this Father's Day message, and I'm so grateful that he's been willing to come and share the gospel with you today. So here in a moment, you'll see Ryan, and he's going to share the message of Christ with you. I encourage you to open your heart and your mind as God speaks through him to each of us.
Hi, my name is Ryan Hayes. I'm happy to be here with you today, and we're glad you're here. Today is Father's Day, and we want to wish everybody a happy Father's Day. I'm the lay leader here at Connect Methodist. I serve with the leadership team, and I'm privileged to learn and grow with my church family. Connect is very close to my heart. I've been a member at Connect for 4 years, and my wife Courtney has been a member for longer than that. Courtney was baptized, and we were married here at Connect by Pastor Adam. Our three daughters, Kendra, Alyssa, and Maddie, are also members. Maddie comes most often, and she wanted to be mentioned here today. So Maddie, here's your mention, and I want to say to you, I love to hear you pray. Today's sermon is going to be on God's love for us as a father. I want to begin by telling you how God's love has affected me in my life. 6.5 years ago, I was a very sick man, mentally, bodily, and spiritually. I was in my own personal opioid epidemic, hopelessly addicted, and I believed there was no way out. I believed that there was no help for me. I ended up in the hospital, and from there, I went to a Christ-centered treatment center in Purcell, Oklahoma, Rob's Ranch. There, I found the help that I needed. I've been sober now for 6.5 years. God's love has been with me throughout my recovery. It was freely given to me, and now I do my best to show God's love to those that need help. Once again, I want to say Happy Father's Day. Today's sermon is going to be a study on Thessalonians, on 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, 11 through 12. Paul writes to the Thessalonians, "And we dealt with each of you as a father deals with his own children, encouraging, comforting, and urging you to live lives worthy of God who calls you into his kingdom and glory." God loves us as a father because he encourages us. Encouragement is so powerful. It can make the insurmountable seem achievable. When we are encouraged, we are lifted up. Last year, my wife and my family moved into our dream home. There was a problem, though, the moving process. We had some really big stuff. Me and the girls were not going to be able to do the moving ourselves. My good friend, Buck, came to help us. With his help, we were able to get moved into our dream home, and we could not be more happy. We were lifted up. Side note, when Buck lifts stuff up, he makes the weirdest noises. So that made the daunting task of moving pretty humorous. So thanks, Buck. Next, let's look at how when we are encouraged, we are empowered. I was 2 years into my recovery and doing very well, but I had no direction in what I was going to do for a career or how God was going to use me. A good friend of mine, Tanner, encouraged me to go back to college and to become a therapist. That dream was already in my heart, but his words empowered me. Empowerment is the fuel that gets you started. I have now completed my master's degree and work at my dream job. I am a therapist at the Christ-based treatment center, which helped me 6.5 years ago. Tanner did not do any of the work for my college degrees. I did the work, but his encouragement empowered me to do it. My wife, Courtney, also had a huge hand in the encouragement of my education. Thank you, Courtney. Next, I would like to talk about how when we are encouraged, we are supported. Let's think of support in the terms of a table. Without the support of the legs and the ground underneath it, the table could not hold up the things put on it. We all have a lot of stuff put on us in life. Encouragement is the way we are supported enough to hold up the things that we need to hold up. Encouragement is so amazing, and it is free to give away. It costs you nothing to give away. Today, I encourage you to do whatever's in front of you. Now that we've talked about encouragement, I want to go back to 1 Thessalonians 2:11 through 12. For now you know that we dealt with each of you as a father deals with his own children, encouraging, comforting, and urging you to live lives worthy of God, who has called you into his kingdom and glory. Now we were going to look at how God loves us as a father because he comforts us. When we are comforted, all of our problems are not fixed. God loves us enough not to fix all of our problems. He might not fix the problem, but he never leaves us alone. Which brings me to my next point. When we are comforted, we are never alone. God's presence is always with us, and that is a promise. Once again, we are going to go back to 1 Thessalonians 2:11 through 12. For you know that we have dealt with each of you as a father deals with his own children, encouraging, comforting, and urging you to live lives worthy of God, who calls you into his kingdom and glory. Last, we were going to look at how God loves us because he urges us. In the last days before I got sober, I felt God urging me to change. I felt deep down inside of me that time was running out. I ended up in the hospital, and when I woke up in the hospital bed, I was terrified and didn't know where I was. I was terrified, but somehow I knew that this was it. It was now or never. Sometimes God loves us enough to tell us when things are not okay. Sometimes the most loving thing is to not comfort us. Sometimes we need to be held accountable and told that what we're doing needs to change. This is an urging from God. God loves us enough to urge us. My wife Courtney's favorite scripture relates to this topic of God's urging love, which is Revelation 3:19. The people I love, I call into account, prod and correct, and guide, so that they will live at their best. Up upon your feet, men. About face, run after God. God's love was urging me to go in a different direction. God's kingdom and glory is a beautiful place to live. Encouragement, comfort, and urging help us get there. I would like to end today's sermon with the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Everybody out there, have a happy Father's Day, and we were just really glad that you were here with us today. Thank you.
We've now reached the point in the worship service where I would like to invite you to take a moment and respond. In this moment, in particular, we ask you to respond through your giving. If you are not a member of Connect Church, we don't have any expectation. We don't want you to feel any obligation to give. This service is our gift to you. But if you do consider Connect your home, it is through your gifts that we're able to do the ministries that we do here. So I encourage you now to click on the link in the description of this video, do your online giving, and I hope that you're blessed as you bless others. Conclude today, I want to give you an opportunity, as we always do, to receive Holy Communion. You may have the small single-serving communion cups from the church. You may have bread and grape juice at home, and I invite you now to take this opportunity to receive Holy Communion. So go ahead and grab your elements and let us pray. Lord God, we ask that you pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and of wine. Make them be for us the body and the blood of Christ, so that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by your blood. Make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with your Holy Spirit and in your Holy Church, all honor and glory is yours, now and forever, Almighty Father. Amen. And now, together, I invite you to join your church family that's scattered around and here in person in the sanctuary as we receive Holy Communion together. I hope you have now great confidence that you've received God's presence and God's grace, that you are being forgiven, transformed, touched by the Lord. As you go from this place today, may you go knowing that you do not walk alone, that God walks right there with you. May you lean on him, may you find his strength, and may you walk with the light that he provides for your path. May you go now in peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.